First option, try Windows Update 3 times. Second option, restart your computer or laptop. With you, I don't ever feel calm. I could feel the sweat inside my palms. Play with me like cats and a string. You don't understand the pain it brings. You don't ever wanna give me wings. You don't ever wanna set me free. You know I'm addicted to you, and it's twisted you've been gifted with the. Third option, turn off receive update for other Microsoft products. Got me coming back for more, even when I've been screwed. Dolls full of pins, pierce my heart straight through. I got issues in my head. I like you in my bed, but you keep me on red. Oh, everything is like a test. I better not text or I'll come off desperate. But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my. Fourth option, run Windows Troubleshoot. Dead, will you regret everything that you did, that you said? I don't think you understand what you're doing. And my heart's black and blue from the bruising. I feel like when I'm with you, I'm losing. I feel like you think that this amusing. Sitting there gaslighting and confusing. Was it me? Is it me? Am I deluded? I'm the one who's always sorry, the conclusion. Fifth option, run system file checker using command prompt. Even though I offer all of the solutions, I wish you loved me like I love you, it's stupid. When I'm alone with you, I never feel lucid. I wish I wasn't struck by Cupid. I wish when I first saw you, I knew this. When I'm with you, I feel so useless. I feel diluted, my heart's been wounded. Silhouettes of you are like a taunt. Never really know just what you want. With you, I don't ever feel calm. I could feel the sweat inside my palm. Play with me like cats and a string. You don't understand the pain. Sixth option, resize partition using command prompt. This process will only work if you run administrator using command prompt. I will be providing all the details on your right side. That will be a step by step from 1 to 20. Just follow the process. First, we type RE. Agent C space slash info and hit enter. Make sure this is enabled, the Windows recovery, otherwise do not continue. Next is to type RE agent C space slash disabled and hit enter. Now let's type disk part and hit enter. So we're inside the disk partition. Let's put list space disk. Take note on the disk number where your Windows recovery is the location. Here I'm using disk 1 or hard disk 1. Now let's type cell space disk 1 and hit enter. Now type list space part and hit enter. Take note on your primary. That will be your partition. For this example, I'll be using partition 3, so type cell space part 3 and hit enter. Next, type shrink space desired equals 250 space minimum equals 250 and hit enter. Now, under recovery, check what partition is the number. For this example, I'll be using partition 5, so type cell space part space number 5 and hit enter. Type delete space partition space override, then press enter.
type list space disk and press enter. Make sure your GPT has an asterisk, otherwise type the code as shown now. If you have asterisk on GPT, let's continue. Type create space partition space primary space ID equals D E 94 B B A 4 minus 06 D 1 minus 4 D 4 0 minus A 16 A minus B F D 50 179 D 6 A C. Then press enter. Next, type GPT space attributes space equals 0 times 8. Make sure you have 14 zeros and then followed 1. So 0 times 8, 14 zeros and then 1. Hit enter. Now type format space quick space fs equals ntfs space label equals open parenthesis and then type windows re space tools close parenthesis and then press enter. Don't worry guys, we're almost done. Type list space vol and then press enter. Now our Windows recovery is now 511 MB. Okay, type exit and then press enter. Type re agent C space slash enable and then press enter. Finally, type re agent C space slash info and then press enter. If everything goes well, you'll see the status enabled. Type exit and press enter. Alright, so let's try if our Windows update will be successful. You don't ever wanna give me wings. It seems the error still appears. How about let's try to restart and try again. Okay guys, since the error still appears, let's proceed to the seventh or last option. Option 7. Save OS Dynamic Update and PowerShell Script. Open any internet browser and then type Microsoft Update Catalog. Select Microsoft Update Catalog. On your top right, under search, type Save OS Dynamic Update and then hit search. From here, choose the correct update on your computer or laptop. To do that, type About PC under Settings. Check your Windows Edition, Version, and also your System Type. Once you know your system settings, go to Download. Next, click on the link below. Using a cab file or what we call cabinet file. You can select anywhere to save your cab file. Now let's open the cab file. Okay guys, there's only one rule here. Just copy this location path. We will use this later on. Next, open any internet browser and type Kb5034957. We will get the script here for our PowerShell to be used later on. Now let's scroll down and look for patch Windows recovery script 2004 plus. So you'll see recommended. Now let's open the patch. So you will begin to copy from param or the syntax name parameter for the PowerShell. Just copy everything until a little bit more, until here, the recurse. Next to do is open your notepad and then paste the script. Okay, so we are going to save this as PostScript. Choose your location for the file and then type script.ps1. Remember, script.ps1, and then press save. Make sure you're using administrator when you open PowerShell. Now type get minus execution policy and then press enter. If the status is restricted, our script will not work. Let us type this code: set minus execution policy space remote signed. Make sure you type the correct code before you press enter. Type Y for yes. We are now able to run our script. First things first, copy the location path of your script. For this example, the location is desktop and the name is script.ps1. Paste here the location of your script. Double check before you press enter. If you have copied correctly the script, it will ask for the package path. This is your cabinet file downloaded from Safe OS Dynamic Update under Microsoft Update Catalog. Now copy the file location and paste it on PowerShell. Then press save. I'm going to fast forward the video since this may take some time in real time. From your end, just wait for it to finish and please do not press anything while the download is on progress. Once done, you'll see a message, the operation completed successfully. Let's type exit and then press enter. Now let's try to update. Guys, well done. We are able to successfully update Kb5034441 or the famous error 0x80070643. Do you find this useful? Please subscribe for more videos.